Angeles. Will it be another Soviet, Natalia Yurchenko? Will it be an East German, Maxi Gonok? Will it be another Romanian, Ekaterina Szabo? Or possibly an American, Julianne McNamara? We'll see them competing today at the World Gymnastics Championships, the most important gymnastic event next to the Olympic Games.
Spanning the globe to bring you the constant variety of sport, the thrill of victory, and the agony of defeat. The human drama of athletic competition. This is ABC's Wide World of Sport.
Brought to you by Texas Instruments, the home computer, creating useful products and services for you. By the Champion Spark Plug Company, nothing sparks like a champion. And by Lincoln Mercury, offering a complete range of quality automobiles for 1984. From front-wheel drive cars to three distinct luxury models, everything from Lynx to Lincoln.
As Budapest, many of the population of 2 million have been filling the seats of the Budapest Sports Hall, a year-old, round, modern, air-conditioned structure, today playing host to the world's greatest gymnasts. The flags of the 41 competing nations decorate this magnificent facility for the World Gymnastic Championships.
Hello, I'm Chris Schenkel. This event in the world of gymnastics is second only to the Olympic Games. Here in Budapest, it takes on added importance because it's the last major competition before the Los Angeles Games, which are only months away. Another important fact, the international judges are taking their last long look at the world's best gymnasts. We await the beginning of the competition in the women's all-around finals. I'm delighted to be working with Kathy Rigby again. And Kathy, the first phase of the ladies' competition has ended.
That's right, Chris. The team competition has been completed, and as expected, the Soviet Union team has won. They were led to victory by Natalia Yurchenko, 18 years old, and she's really dominated the scene in gymnastics for most of the year. There were some big surprises. Maxi Gonok of East Germany, who apparently fully recovered from major elbow surgery, began this event as one of the favorites and was leading during the preliminary portion of the event. However, she faltered badly on the floor exercise and impaired her chances of winning here. Meanwhile, the defending Soviet world champion Olga Bichurova performed poorly enough to be eliminated from the competition entirely when three of her teammates outscored her. The rules state only the top three from any country can compete in the finals. Meanwhile, Julianne McNamara of the United States, who was the leading American qualifier and was a medalist at the last World Championships, has been struggling somewhat throughout the competition.
And with each of the gymnasts still having two pieces of apparatus to compete on, Natalia Yurchenko continues to lead. Julianne McNamara of the United States is currently in 17th place. Several key sports figures in attendance here. Second from the left, Juan Antonio Samaranch, president of the International Olympic Committee, and on the far left, Yuri Titov of the Soviet Union, president of the International Gymnastic Federation. Moving now to the vault, Lavinia Agaki of Romania, 4'11", 84 pounds, and talented.
Talented and really dynamite. She does a full twisting front somi, difficult to land. You can't see where that floor is coming unless you're looking at it. Line move, very good vault, high in the air, really stretched out long, good distance from the horse. Take another look. You really have to jam into that horse. Good run here. Powerful. See, she comes into the horse, pushes hard, gets good height. You see, she can't see that ground until she's actually on it. Nice vault.
9.90 added to her previous scores temporarily puts Agaki into the lead. Up next in the vault will be the United States' Julianne McNamara, who's been struggling somewhat, as Kathy indicated. Kathy also asked Julianne if she was pleased with her performance thus far.
Yes, actually, I'm really pleased. I think I could have done a little better on a few things, but I'm really happy to be competing. I caught the flu when I first got here, and I was kind of wondering if I was going to be able to compete, so I'm just happy to be here.
Julianne, you talk about your own illness, and yet several key members of the United States team are not here because of illness or injury, such as Mary Lou Retton, Tracy Talavera, Diane Durham. Now, when they return to the team, do you think that'll take some of the pressure off of you?
Well, I really never felt that much pressure in that way. I just, if anything, I put pressure on myself because I want to do the best for myself and for the United States. Mm-hmm. So I think you just have to learn to deal with that.
How do you deal with pressure? What do you say to yourself right before you go on a piece of apparatus?
Mainly I just try to calm myself down and just, I pretend that I'm in practice because I practice these routines every day and most of the time I'll hit my routines every day, and that's all you have to do. You just have to come to the meet and show everybody that you can do it. And that's why it's so frustrating when you come into a meet and you hit your routines every day and work out, and then that one routine you mess up.
Right.
But that's the name of the game.
You know, Chris, she really does look a little tired and draw. When you're expending mm-hmm. so much energy on routines and the added pressure of competition, it's difficult to hit those routines and have the sparkle. Full twist in Sukahara, step there, a little low in the shoulders. She just doesn't seem to have the punch. You can see it on her face here. She's just a little tired there. She runs well. You really have to jam out of those shoulders and punch hard with those arms and upper body. A little flat there. Not bad, though. She gets good distance from the horse. That step is going to cost her a few tenths.
And here's her mark. Not bad either, Kathy. 9.85.
Unfortunately, Chris, she's been struggling so much through the competition. I don't think this is going to help her score much.
Julianne McNamara. And now we turn our attention to another American, 16-year-old Tanya Service, St. Charles, Missouri, in the standings, currently 23rd.
She's going to do a layout Sukahara. And Chris, what a surprise she's been here in Budapest. Interesting story behind Tanya. Due to an earlier injury she had, not qualified for the World Championship trials in the United States, so she had to petition to get in. Mainly, she just wanted the experience of national competition. She did not place in the top 10, but because of many injuries, she became an alternate for the World Championship team. She came here, and another injury to one of the American women put her in the competition, and now she's one of the finalists here in the all-around. Not bad.
A gritty competitor, and gets a 9.80. Remarkable, after shattering an ankle only 9 months ago. Two of the many magnificent works of art. First, the huge bronze equestrian statue of Hungary's first king, Stefan, the year 1000. And alongside, beautiful and historic 13th century Matthias Church, often called Coronation Church, in which the last two kings of Hungary were crowned. On the floor exercise, Ekaterina Szabo, 16-year-old Romanian, who needs a 9.75 to take the lead.
Chris, that's totally within her range. It's interesting, the Romanians have come back. After the 76 Olympics, they seem to have gone downhill a little bit, and they didn't seem to have the depth, but with gymnasts like Ekaterina, they are on their way upward. And you can see with her first tumbling run, it's got full twisting, double back in a pike position, just how much strength she has. Very nice. So difficult to do. Flexibility. Very innovative tumbling run coming up. Down off back hamstring. One and a half twist. Another one and a half twist. Right into a punch front. Have really come a long way in their dance and choreography. It's really improved. Just to show the strength in her tumbling, she should throw a full in double back again. Very nice. What endurance.
Oh, that was a happy performance, and the crowd here in Budapest loving it. Will the four judges love it as much?
They should, Chris. Let's take another look at her slow motion, full in, double back. You know, Chris, it's interesting because the floors now have springs under them, which helps these girls in their tumbling a great deal. Right on.
We'll have her mark in a moment, but first we've got to move quickly. The uneven bars, Olga Mustapanova of the Soviet Union. A 10 for Szabo here in Budapest, putting her into the lead.
Can't beat that. Here's another gymnast, the great possibilities, good depth on the Russian team, and this is the gymnast that's going to be hard to beat in 1984. Stalter's now, giant swing, getting ready for a dismount. Brought with a half twist way above the bar. Very nice.
This 15-year-old needing a 9.7 to take the lead. Ponytail and all, Mashta Panova, the Soviet Union.
She had a slight break on the Indian bar. It's going to be difficult to say whether she can get that. She hit her heel on this reverse hecht. She lifts real high, really have to pull with those arms, way above the bar. But you can see there, her left foot hit the bar slightly.
And now the lead changes again, Kathy. A 9.8 for Mashta Panova of the Soviet Union. And we move over to her teammate on the 4-inch wide beam. Natalia Yurchenko, who came into this phase of the competition in the lead, needs a 9.7 to regain it.
A little hop there on her mount. As we've said many times on this apparatus, it can make or break you. Least amount of room for error here. And with all the tumbling and leaping they're doing nowadays, falling off is not uncommon. Very nice back handspring right into a back layout. Showing flexibility.
Look how she uses all of it.
That's one of the requirements, Chris.
Does she remind you of any of the other Soviet gymnasts?
I was just thinking she does remind me of Ludmila an awful lot, who is one of the judges in this competition.
It's a high compliment.
Yes. She's a beautiful gymnast. And unlike some of the little pixie types you see quite often. Now watch this move. Back handspring right into a back hip circle, something normally done on the uneven bars, but now it's on the balance beam. She is moving rather slowly, very methodically. Whip handstand. So far, no major breaks, a few bobbles, but not more than a half a tenth each. See, she's concentrated on every move. We try to have tunnel vision here. 4 inches wide, round off, back hand, back, double back. Good landing, good exercise.
Yurchenko, a little larger than most of the Eastern Europeans at 5 feet, 2.5 inches and 100 pounds.
You really have to line yourself up. Back handspring right into a back layout, shoulders between the balance beam at all times, right into a back walkover. This is where she shows her flexibility. Look at that split, good toe point.
And Yurchenko gets a 9.90, regaining the lead in this tight world championship. We'll be back. Here in Budapest, we find one of the oldest subway systems in the world. In fact, the oldest in Eastern Europe, having been built in 1877. Also in Budapest, you'll find one of the most modern systems in the entire world. The stations are adorned with route maps, similar to those that you do find in a city like New York. Now, the cost to ride it, 1 forint, the equivalent to 2.5 cents in American money. And in the sports hall, floor exercise, 15-year-old Boryana Stoyanova.
She's quite a tumbler. In fact, that's really the strongest part of her exercise. She begins with a full in, double back in the pike position. Goes to her corner.
Again, another young one from Bulgaria, 15 years of age.
Watch this. Right to the corner. Her dance is really the weakest part of her exercise, although it's not bad, but her toes, every time they come off the ground, should be pointed instead of quite so flat-footed, but she's excellent here. This is her second tumbling run. She has a whip over right into a double back, really one of my favorites.
And this event, the only event in all of gymnastics where music goes along with the performance, and in this case, it's recorded.
It used to be just the piano, one instrument, but now it's orchestration. So it's her third tumbling run, a double twist. She actually has 4 tumbling runs, which is unusual. You need a lot of endurance here for her double back. Done so easily. Nice exercise.
Poise for a 15-year-old in her first world championship. Crowd loving her, and so do we, Boryana Stoyanova.
What a powerful gymnast. Not only does she vault well, but her tumbling is so exceptional. Round off back handspring. Good height here. Especially for an ending. Lots of endurance needed.
And a 9.90, the crowd feeling she deserved more.
Well, her tumbling is fabulous, but her dance could improve a little.
Now, with one rotation left the standings, Yurchenko in the lead, Mostapanova second, Szabo is third. Natalia Yurchenko trying to become the sixth consecutive world all-around champion to hail from the Soviet Union. That string beginning at 70 and 74, Ludmila Tereshcheva, Elena Mukina in 78, Nellie Kim winning it in 1979, and Olga Bechurova in 1981. So here in Budapest, shortly we'll find out whether Natalia Yurchenko of the Soviet Union can win the world's women's all-around championship. Earlier, her teammate, Dmitry Bilazerchev, won the men's all-around championship, and what a performance. And that's why we're happy to bring in and introduce three-time world champion, Kurt Thomas. Kurt, he was incredible.
He really was. This kid has consistency. He's got strength. He's got flexibility. All the qualities to be the best in the world, and he is. He is a tremendous performer. People are going to have to look out for this young man in Los Angeles in 1984. He's the youngest man ever to win the World Gymnastic Championships at the age of 16. And in my opinion, this young man's got all the ingredients to continue to dominate. He's got the creative qualities of Olga Korbut, the consistency of Nadia Comaneci. And when you put those two together, you come out with Dmitry Bilazerchev. Physically, he's very, very strong. In fact, the first part of his ring routine consists of nothing but strength moves. But above and beyond his physical strength, Dmitry has the mental ability to go all out in every exercise, which is something that's usually developed through experience. The head coach of the Soviet national team, Leonid Arkayev, once said that Dmitry's best qualities is that he's never disturbed by circumstances. His only concern is his precise execution of his routines. Well, Dmitry is now the all-time high scorer in the World Gymnastic Championships with a score of 119.20 out of a possible 120. Going into the last event, the floor exercise, he only needed a 9.25 to win the all-around championship. But because of the true champion he really is, he went out with a bang by scoring a perfect 10-0. Well, all eyes will be on this young man, and the rest of the world will certainly have their work cut out for them. Dmitry Bilazerchev.
We'll be back with more of the women's competition to see if Natalia Yurchenko can match her Soviet teammate's achievement. Right now, we go to Ireland for the Dublin Mile and Bill Fleming. In Hungarian art, it sets on the Buda side of the Danube here in Budapest, which is the capital of Hungary, comparable in size to either Ireland or Indiana. We're on the Pest side at the World Gymnastics Championships, and each of the gymnasts has one more apparatus on which to perform. The standings are Natalia Yurchenko in the lead, Olga Mostapanova second, Ekaterina Szabo third. They're trying to win a title so difficult to win that it eluded even Olga Korbut and Nadia Comaneci. I'm Chris Schenkel along with Kathy Rigby. From East Germany, here she is, the veteran, world champion before, now in the fourth and final rotation on the vault.
She does a full twist in Sukahara. A little off to the side, a little off in direction, which the judges will take off for. She's really had a poor meet.
Fifth coming into this final competition in the all-around has dropped to eighth.
You know, Chris, she is the defending world champion on the vault, although she's never been able to win an all-around competition. And I think that if she can stay physically and mentally healthy by 84, she has a good chance to win there in the all-around.
And this performance for Maxi Ganok, a 9.85. Next to perform, America's veteran, 24-year-old Kathy Johnson in her fourth world championship. Earlier, Kathy Rigby talked to her about being the veteran of the team.
Kathy, you've been in gymnastics probably longer than anybody in this gym, competition hall tonight. Was there ever a time that you just wanted to give it all up?
Oh, sure. You know, when I realized that I was human, you know, could make mistakes, because for a while I that was so hard to accept. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I started listening to everybody else. Well, at a certain age, gymnastics is over with. Mm-hmm. And then I don't know, I just decided that, hey, I love the sport and I want to be fully satisfied when I retire. Mm-hmm. So that I could go on and coach or judge and feel good about myself and what I did. Mm-hmm. And then I can help someone else better.
Now, what will you do to get ready for the Olympics? This is the last big competition before the Olympics. Is there anything special you're going to do?
Well, this is the best thing that could happen to me for the Olympics, because I feel right in there with the rest of the world, even though they're 7 years younger. You know, and I even feel like I can learn a couple new things, mm-hmm. which would be exciting for me as well. Mm-hmm. Now I know I want to even get stronger, mm-hmm. and we've really upped our strength workouts and endurance. And hopefully I'll be 3 times better by 84.
Kathy Johnson, hometown in the Atlantic, Florida, now residing in Huntington Beach, California.
Kathy's done a remarkable job here. She's been so confident, so secure. She had one break in the team competition, which put her down just a little for this competition, but she's moved very well on all apparatuses. She's doing a layout Sukihara. Good position in the air, a little hop back, but not bad.
In her 3 exercises in the finals here today, she's had 3 9-8s. Let's see what she does here. And upping it, 9.90, wonderful.
You have to be so pleased for her. She's really worked hard here, and she's done a great job. The oldest competitor in the gym today.
And now we get to the crucial stage of the competition. First up of the 3 leaders, Ekaterina Szabo of Romania. 9.65 would make her the leader, with Yurchenko and Mastepanova still to perform the last of the 4 events.
That's very much within her range. This is a particularly good event for her. She's going to do what's called a Cuervo vault, handspring front with a half twist back out. It's a relatively new vault.
She looks pleased.
She should be. It's a perfect landing. Nothing wrong with that.
Wisely playing to the crowd.
We'll take another look at that in slow motion. You can see a little bit better how the vault is done. Run is so important. Have to build up a lot of power, jam into the horse, get a lot of height, make a half twist, back out. Good landing.
And here's the mark. Another perfect 10 for Szabo of Romania. And Yurchenko and Mastepanova have their work cut out. I'm looking around the unusual city today of Budapest, long famed for its many natural mineral hot springs. A most unusual sight, an actual hot waterfall. People from all over Hungary come to Margaret Island on the Danube between Buda and Pest, visiting one of the 123 mineral springs. Spas all over the city, reportedly relaxing and therapeutic. Here she is, tiny Olga Mastepanova, 4th and final event. And at this point, she needs a 9.9 to take the lead, Kathy.
And she could do it on this event. Beautiful flexibility, strong. That was a back handspring into a back handspring with a half twist. Body has to be centered right over the balance beam. Just shows you the depth the Russian team has.
Her teammate, Natalia Yurchenko, next to compete.
Covered up a little bobble there on that turn. Back handspring right into a back layout. A little slight bobble there. Back walkover. Fully extends every move. She has the flexibility and the strength. Many times when a gymnast has flexibility, they don't have the strength to move their body as quickly as possible. Very nice flexibility. You can see her concentrating. Getting now to a dismount. Round off, double back, good landing.
15-year-old Olga Mastepanova of the Soviet Union.
Control is the name of the game on this apparatus. Full turn. You can see there she had that little slight bobble there on the full turn, but nobody can even notice it. And now here's her back handspring right into a back layout. She did make a slight break here, and you can bet the judges will see that.
Mastepanova, 9.9 in Kathy's. You said the first bobble they didn't see. And she is the new leader. As we move to the 4 exercise, this young lady, 18-year-old from Soviet Union, Natalia Yurchenko, has been number 1 from the start. Through 3 rotations, is still number 1, but she needs a 9.70 to become the world all-around woman's champion.
And that is totally in her range. You know, Chris, I hope that this young lady can influence the rest of the gymnastic world with her style. She is so beautiful, so lyrical on the floor exercise. She reminds you of Tereshkova, Latynina, some of the names you've heard in the past. Opens with a full and double back. Well done. Perfect. Very graceful in every move. Every time her foot comes off that floor, toes are pointed, legs are fully extended. Getting ready now for her second tumbling run. Down off back handspring, whip over back handspring, double back, good combination. Chest roll. Look at that expression.
See the feet?
Yes. Beautifully done. Right into a gainer, back handspring. When they walk to the corner like that, it's just getting them a little bit prepared, giving them a little bit of rest before the last tumbling run. Double back. Can't do much better than that.
The right ankle and foot taped. A great gymnast from the Soviet Union, Natalia Yurchenko, after team competition, came into the women's finals all around. The leader has held it all the way through three events, including a 10 on the vault.
Great preview for the Olympics.
Her other scores, 9.85 on the uneven bars, and on the beam, 9.90. And there's a 10! Two 10s, and of course, out of four events, she is the 1983 world champion. Lookout Los Angeles.
And the coach is over there giving him a big hug. You know, it's so important. Recognition is so important to the Soviet gymnast.
And we must recognize Julianne McNamara, the last performance by an American in this championship.
She's one of America's hopes for a medal in 1984 on this event. She won the bronze medal in the last world championships on this event. Although she has had some difficulty in competition here at the World Championship. She's been ill prior to the meet. Moving well now. This is her event. Perfect positioning. Right into a front somi. So smooth. She almost stops those handstands right at the top. Can't get much better than that. Stalls her to a handstand. Right on. Front to a half. Very nice routine.
Absolutely beautiful, and the crowd loving it here. Capacity crowd. Bro Kreitzer of the U.S. team cheering her on. Exhaustion, signs of the illness.
But a true champ, really pulling through that routine. You can really see the beauty of a routine when you watch it in slow motion. Straddle, right through a double leg shoot through. She just moves so fluidly. Straight arms on the kip, right to a stalter here. Watch how she stops it, right at the top. That's exactly what the judges are looking for, way above the bar on the dismount. And no steps.
And here's the mark, a 9.9, and listen to that crowd whistling in protest. Kathy, did you see any faults?
You know, Chris, even in slow motion, she had all the difficulty, the technique was right there, and compared to some of the other routines, I don't see why she didn't receive a 10 also.
And the Americans now are lodging a protest to Eastern Bloc judging bias, perhaps. Well, we'll be back in a minute to see if the protest is upheld.
And with me is Julianne McNamara. What superb uneven bar routine. How'd you feel about it?
Well, I felt really great. I kind of had some trouble on the first couple events, so felt good to finish strong.
The crowd was with you, and I noticed that there was a lot of whistling. They really didn't like your score. How did you feel about it?
Well, in comparison to some of the scores on the other routines, I think I could have gotten a little higher, maybe.
You know, we talked to you earlier in an interview, and you told us about your illness in Germany. Did you feel bad or tired in this competition?
Well, I've been feeling kind of a little bit weaker than I usually do, and I think the night before the adrenaline kind of took me through it, and I think now I'm getting a little tired, but I was just a little unlucky, I think.
Well, good luck, and in LA, I'm sure things will pick up for you.
Thank you.
We've just received word that the American protest has been disallowed. Julianne McNamara's 9.9 will stand. The results are official. The new champion, Natalia Yurchenko. The top American finisher, Kathy Johnson, 11th.
It's difficult to assess the U.S. women's team for the Olympics since so many weren't here due to illness and injury, and it was obvious throughout the competition Julianne wasn't up to par because of illness.
As for the new world all-around champion, Yurchenko, what's her background in the sport?
She started gymnastics when she was 8, and she didn't have some problems with her feet and then her elbows, and it took her a long time to recover from it. And it's only in 81 that she got back to competition.
So she returned to competition in 1981, and 2 years later rises to the very top and sets herself up as the one to beat in Los Angeles. The executive producer of ABC Sports is Rune Arledge. Coordinating producer of ABC's Wide World of Sports, Dennis Lewin, who also produced our coverage of the World Gymnastics Championships, which was directed by Bob Lanning. Dublin Mile produced by Joel Feld. Our director in Dublin was Jeff Cohan. World Speedway Motorcycle Championships produced by Mike Pearl. Coordinator, Carol Letty. Associate directors, Norm Salmon, Ben Harvey, and Robert Cowan. ABC's Wide World of Sports will return 2 weeks from today with the International Professional Figure Skating Championships for ladies and men from Madison Square Garden, along with the World Weightlifting Championships from Moscow. Travel arrangements made through and a promotional fee paid by United Airlines, the official airline of the 1984 Los Angeles Olympic Games and proud sponsor of the United States Olympic team.
ABC's Wide World of Sports has been brought to you by Budweiser, the king of beers and proud sponsor of the U.S.